pristine farmland.
It's river bottom. When it's clay-based like this, it holds the moisture.
What looks like Vermont, maybe Maine, until the commuter rail roars through, is Acton, 25 miles from Boston. This is home to Idylewild Farms and the Napoli family.
Three uncles, they've all got sons here that work here.
The sons, that's Joe, are the fourth generation in this farming family. From the 80 acres of fields to the farm stand that has grown and grown and grown over the years, there is no shortage of Napolis tending crops and a whole lot more. Richard Napoli.
Just a little log cabin that was just struggling to get by, and we decided we wanted to keep doing this. It was in our blood because we were taught pretty well. We started with good quality farm-grown produce, evolved it to more products that people were looking for. People were coming here for this, and while they were here, they were interested in other good products.
I'm here almost every day. I love this place.
We love the corn here. We love all the fruits and vegetables here.
I drive 2 hours to get here.
Idylewild is the best.
The heart of Idylewild is the farm itself, Tom Napoli's pride and joy.
This is one of our better sellers. It's what we call golden zucchini. We have to pick this squash every day. It grows this much. So we're planting cauliflower here. Because of the shortage in labor, we have to mechanize as much as we can. We can put 800 plants on the machine at one time. They drop the plants in a tiny hole, and the press wheels in the back press it together, and it's pretty much done.
Ripe for picking now, corn.
Beautiful. Doesn't get any fresher. This is the butter and sugar variety. That's all we grow here at the farm. We plant corn in succession every 8 to 10 days. So we'll have corn from the middle of July all the way until Columbus Day. We pick it at usually 7 in the morning. It's on our customers' dinner table at 6 at night.
Crops Idylewild doesn't grow, says Tom, are sourced from other local farms. The custom post and beam stand houses everything from a greenhouse to specialty foods and wine. What's missing? A sign.
I really don't have a good explanation except that there was just too much bother.
No sign, no advertising, and no shortage of customers. The Napolis credit their success to being in the right place at the right time.
In the spring of 71, a gentleman came through the front door and told us that our struggles were over and we were going to be fine. He said, I just bought the Maynard clock tower. My name is Ken Olson.
Digital, the computer giant, changed the local landscape.
The population exploded. People wanted good schools and good food. So we don't need a sign.
Signs are overrated. As Tom Napoli says, whatever they grow, they sell. From the farm to the table, no packaging, no boxing, no transportation. And now Idylewild does sell products from other local farms, and they make a point of letting customers know where everything comes from. For example, on the day we visited, they were selling tomatoes from where else? Wardsbury Farm. The growing season there runs March to October, and then the farm stand goes into holiday mode, selling turkeys and Christmas trees. Now, 3 years after they married, he dropped a bombshell. Next.
Mark told me he'd like to start farming and quit his job.